Another suspect in the murder of Sheffield grandmother Mary Pat O'Hagan stood before a federal judge today, this time for an unrelated crime. News Channel 5's Vanessa Mashanya has this crime beat report live from the newsroom tonight. Vanessa?
One day after evidence of Richard Fletcher's role in O'Hagan's killing had an impact on his child porn sentence, a second suspect, Michael Norrey, appeared in the same courtroom, not for murder charges, but for plea change in an unrelated crime.
22-year-old Michael Norrey stood before the same judge that his cousin, Richard Fletcher, did on Tuesday. Both men, along with Fletcher's brother Keith Baird, are suspects in the 2010 murder of Mary Pat O'Hagan. Just like his cousin, Norrey was in federal court for charges unrelated to the murder. On Tuesday, Fletcher was sentenced to almost 16 years in prison for child porn production. The judge tacked on extra time beyond the mandatory 15-year minimum because she was convinced he played a part in O'Hagan's murder, though he has not been charged for it.
He went through a fair system. He was found to be responsible, and there's no punishment for it.
On Wednesday, Norrey changed his plea to guilty on two 2009 felony firearms charges. Like Fletcher, Norrey was recorded by state police admitting his involvement in the Sheffield woman's murder. Prosecutors say they will use those tapes along with witness testimony in Norrey's sentencing hearing. The fact the state hasn't charged the men with the murder has O'Hagan's family frustrated.
And it's not the people, it's the process, it's the system. That there's just, there's a disregard for life, and there's a disregard for the people that are harmed.
Pat O'Hagan's body was found in Wheelock in 2010 after she disappeared from her home. Investigators and O'Hagan's family hope the men are charged before time runs out.
According to Vermont state law, a murder case only has 3 years for it to go to trial. The deadline in O'Hagan's case is up in September. The brothers say they're hoping that between now and then, someone with any information will be able to come forward in the killing of their mother.
To extend the statement of limitation beyond 3 years, or these guys are going to walk. They're going to be among you. And they're going to do it again.
As the deadline approaches, the O'Hagan family will continue to work with police and follow the suspects' cases on the unrelated charges.
We just met with the state police upstairs. Okay, what's the next steps? What are you going to be able to do? We can't talk about it, but I mean, they want to see this thing through as well. We're not giving up.
Each of Norrey's firearms counts carry a maximum sentence of 10 years and a fine up to $250,000. His sentence hearing will be on November 13th of this year. Live in the newsroom, Vanessa Mashanya, News Channel 5.